While our stars of the pool are busy preparing for the London Games, their union, headed by Olympic gold and silver medallist Daniel Kowalski, says Swimming Australia's pay structure is too top-heavy. Kowalski is furious. A new pay model has been signed off without his consent. Under the new deal, our London representatives will receive a minimum $10,000 each. Gold medalists in London will receive another $35,000. Kowalski fears swimmers who aren't household names like James Magnusson and Stephanie Rice will be forced out of the sport. Joining us now to talk more swimming is one of Australia's superfish, two-time Paralympian Matt Cowdrey, who was today named in Australia's 35-member team for the London Paralympics. Matt, we'll talk about the financial issues in a moment, but first, congratulations, you're off to another Paralympic Games.
Thanks, Brad. Cheers.
You're still only 23, Matt. You need three more gold to eclipse runner Tim Sullivan's record of 10. I know you say it probably isn't in the front of your mind, but I bet you it is. It must be.
Well, it's definitely not the reason I'm getting out of the bed every morning, that's for sure. But it definitely is something that you sort of think about. It's something that would be a great thing to retire on, knowing that you'd managed to become Australia's greatest ever Paralympian. And it would be a huge honour and something that I'd be very proud to continue to hold the mantle with.
Matt, you won 5 gold, 3 silver at the last Olympics. Are you a better swimmer now?
Definitely. I've definitely progressed, and the progression and the lead up to this Games has been slightly different for me. I guess I've sacrificed more than I ever have this time round, moving to Canberra in 2010 and then up to the Sunshine Coast in 2011, and being lucky enough to return to Adelaide at the beginning of this year post the trials in March, having obviously being an Adelaide boy, being able to return home, return to my old coach Peter Bishop, and the fantastic facility that we now have down at Marion at the South Australian Aquatic and Leisure Centre is fantastic.
Matt, I feel like we're kind of getting wall-to-wall coverage at the moment of our chances for the able-bodied Olympics. Who are we looking out for at your end of the spectrum? Because I feel like we're not quite hearing enough about it.
Well, it's going to be a great time for us in London. We've got a great mix on our team now of youth and guys that are very experienced. We've got 17 that are returning, 10 for their second Games that went to Beijing, and we've got a few left over from Athens still, and 18 that are coming to their first game. So it's a great mix of youth and experience as well. But a guy named Brendan Hull, an S9, who's been lucky enough, I've been lucky to handball the 400 freestyle over to him. He's the current world record holder and world champion, and looking like he's going to hopefully dominate that 400 freestyle. But we've got a great number of young guys coming up as well. Our youngest swimmer on the team, young Maddie Elliott, is just 13 years of age, so she's going to be one to look out for in the future as well.
All right, let's talk Turkey. Are you underpaid? Are the swimmers, Olympic and Paralympic, underpaid in your view?
Well, I'm lucky enough to be part of the board of the Australian Swimmers Association as well, which Daniel is obviously our CEO, and it is something that's been an issue for a little while as well. But in terms of this new pay model, Paralympic swimmers aren't involved in that, so that's something that we don't have to worry too much about ourselves. But look, every swimmer out there wants to make sure that we're looking after our whole team. For us personally, there's a lot of members that go into helping us achieve as a team in London for sure. And it's not just guys that swim the finals, it's the guys that swim the heats in the relays as well. So we're talking about 8 guys that contribute to a medal there. So we're looking to help our guys that are there representing our country, doing their best, and the guys that are maybe not household names but are there helping and doing their part for the team.
Just out of interest, are Paralympic swimmers paid less than Olympic swimmers?
We have a separate funding model, and that's up to the guys of Swimming Australia and of sorts to sort out. I don't think it's been finalised yet before the Paralympic Games.
All right. Well, I think we probably all hope you do get paid equally.
Yeah, absolutely we do. Good on you, Matt. We really appreciate your time. Good luck to you and the entire Australian team at the London Paralympics kicking off August 29.
Thanks very much, guys.